I was so excited when I saw the title of your plenary talk and Entropy in Medical Education. And I was like, wow, this is so timely because everything is changing right now. And I just want to know what inspired you to change your topic and talk about entropy?
So like I said, I came from the UK, and my experience in the UK is everything falling apart. It's an old country surrounded with ruins, ends of industry. I grew up, I'm sort of Gen X, so I'm kind of I can't call us the Joy Division generation. Essentially, we're very much end of empire, end of class society, although frankly it's still very much there. And it's all about, for me, that the world growing up was all about things falling apart. So partly it's that, but also I studied physics at university for my undergrad, amongst other things, and I remember clearly one of the early classes talking about the decay of atoms, and it starts off with radioactive decay of uranium and iodine and things like that, but quickly moved on to the fact that all atoms decay, that even hydrogen, oxygen, and iron decays, that everything has a half-life. They may be very, very long half-lives, but everything decays. And it's that almost existential understanding that the entire universe, on pointing along time's arrow, is just running down into this gray fog of nothingness. It really, 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 really struck me. And it was a sort of wonderful counterpoint to this sort of history, and coming from an old place with a deep history, plus the physics of it, that really made me think a lot about entropy. And then ever since, it keeps coming up again and again. And with the work that I do, for a long time I was engaged in educational technology, and the thing that really struck me about educational technology is we would do something and it would go away, and then something else would happen, and then something else would happen, and all the time there's this sort of landfill of all the stuff that we generated that nobody was using anymore. I mean, this is sort of only at the early web and pre-web, so we were still thinking about floppy disks and CD-ROMs and laser discs, even those kind of things. And the platform would change, so the material was still viable, but you couldn't play that anymore. And now you couldn't play that anymore. Now that won't work. And then it moved on and moved on. And so there's this sense of attrition that's built up. And then in recent years, my work has been looking at a lot of work around what I've come to see as an issue of compromise, in the sense of there are lots of different drivers on driving us to different kinds of decisions in medical education, and we're always making compromises. We never do the perfect right thing. There's no perfect right thing to do, because we could follow this agenda and say, well, okay, it's right in this paradigm, but that's completely the wrong thing to do in that paradigm, and so on and so on and so on. And so what we see is that all implementations of changes, Diane Dolmans in the Netherlands has done some great work on the decay of problem-based learning. Lara Varpio did a great paper on team-based learning, and is it still team-based learning if they change bits of it, and so on. And it's all these kind of issues about, well, nothing is ever perfect and everything changes and everything falls apart, that really brought me to the decision to talk about entropy. Entropy, not just in terms of, well, everything falls apart and there's this sort of schadenfreude of the universe decaying into nothingness, which kind of leads to a sort of somewhat anarchistic and nihilistic view, but one where we can embrace that, one way we can understand that as a strength. And I intend to draw on concepts of wabi-sabi from Japanese culture, which is the beauty of decay, is that the impermanence of things, the way they change, way they fall apart, actually is a reflection of the universe, and is a strength, and has great aesthetic value. And maybe it's not just an issue of just confronting this inevitable decay, but embracing it and doing something creative and positive with it, rather than only resisting it or trying to deny that time's arrow does have its grasp on pretty much everything we do.